فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
باب ما جاء في غربة الإسلام والفضل الغرباء. وقول الله تعالى: فلولا كان من القرون من قبلكم أولو بقية ينهون عن الفساد في الأرض. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه مرفوعا: بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا كما بدأ. عقوبة للغرباء. رواه مسلم. ورواه الإمام أحمد من حديث ابن مسعود، وفيه قيل: ومن الغرباء؟ قال: النزاع من القبائل. وفي رواية: الغرباء الذين يصلحون إذا فسد الناس. ورواه الإمام أحمد من حديث سعد بن أبي وقاص، وفيه: فطوبى يومئذ للغرباء إذا فسد الناس. وللترمذي من حديث كثير ابن عبد الله عن أبيه عن جدي: طوبى للغرباء الذين يصلحون ما أفسد الناس من سنتي. وعن أبي أمية قال: سألت أبا ثعلبة الحشري فقلت: يا أبا ثعلبة، كيف تقول في هذه الآية: يا أيها الذين آمنوا عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم
عليكم
أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم الآية؟ نو. قال: أما والله لقد سألت عنها خبيرا. سألت عنها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: بل ائتمروا بالمعروف وتناهوا عن المنكر، حتى إذا رأيتهم شحا مطاعا وهوى متبعا والدنيا مؤثرة وإعجاب كل ذي رأي برأيه، فعليك بنفسك ودع عنك العوام، فإن من ورائكم أيام الصبر القابض فيهن على دينه كالقابض على الجمع، للعامل فيهن مثل أجر 50 رجلا يعملون مثل عملكم. قلنا: منا أو منهم؟ قال: بل منكم. رواه أبو داود والترمذي. وروى ابن وضاح معناه من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما.
وروى ابن وضاح معناه
من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما، ولفظه: إن من بعدكم أيام الصابر فيها المتمسك بمثل ما أنتم عليه اليوم، له أجر 50 منكم. ثم قال: أنبأنا محمد بن سعيد، أنبأنا أسد، قال: أخبرنا سفيان بن عيينة عن أسلم البصري، عن سعيد الأخي الحسن يرفعه، قال: إنكم اليوم على بينة من ربكم، تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتجاهدون في سبيل الله، ولم تظهر فيكم السكرة الجهل وسكرة حب العيش، وستحولون عن ذلك. فالمتمسك يومئذ بالكتاب والسنة له أجر 50. قيل: منهم؟ قال: بل منكم. وله بإسناده عن المعافري قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: طوبى للغرباء الذين يتمسكون بكتاب الله حين يفرق ويعملون بالسنة حين تطفأ.
The author, rahimahullah, here he talks about wuqu'u ghurbati al-Islam, that Islam is going to be strange. And he talks about fadl al-ghuraba'i, the virtue of the strangers. And that the strangers are the ones who are little in number. They are alone. And the strangers in Islam are two types. The first one is al-ghurbatu al-qadariyya. The ghurbatu al-qadariyya, which are the universal strangeness, and that is for the Muslims, all of them, over the disbelievers. The Muslims are strangers over the disbelievers. Then the second one is al-ghurbatu shar'iyya. It is for lil-muslim al-muttabi'u hadiya an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bayna al-muslimin. It is the one who is is a Muslim with the Muslims, but he is upon the path of the messenger, dressing like the messenger, upon the tariqah of the messenger, this one is even more of a stranger over the rest of the other Muslims. So he feels two ghurba. The first one is ghurba to Islam with the Muslims. So when the media is attacking, he's being attacked as a Muslim. And he's also another gharib within the Muslim community as a person who's holding on to the sunnah and keeping his garment above his ankles. He becomes gharib. And that's what the author, rahimahullah, here in the chapter is talking about. And the author, rahimahullah, he brings 9 evidences for this. The first evidence is, فَلَوْلَا كَانَ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ أُولُو بَقِيَّةٍ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْفَسَادِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِمَّنْ أَنْجَيْنَا مِنْهُمْ. That's what he wants from the ayah. إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, only little, مِمَّنْ أَنْجَيْنَا مِنْهُمْ, which we saved. The rest, the majority were destroyed. Allah only saved a minority, a very small amount. فَالنَّاجِ قَلِيل, the ones who are saved are little. وَالْقَلِيل يَكُونُ غَرِيبًا, the little are the ones who are strangers. And the fact that Allah saved them is what? دَالَّةٌ عَلَىٰ فَضْلِهِمْ, it shows their virtue. Their virtue is that they are strangers. That's why they were saved. The second evidence that the author uses is the hadith of Abi Huraira. The second evidence that the author uses is the hadith of Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, marfu'an, bada al-islamu ghariban, Islam started off strange, wa sayaudu ghariban, and Islam will go back to being strange. Fatuba lil ghuraba, glad tidings, glad tidings for the stranger. Rawahu Muslim, and Imam Muslim narrated this. The author here, his dilala of the hadith, the usage of the hadith, is zahira, it's apparent, right? What he's using it for. Because in it, this hadith is what? Khabar al-Sadiq al-Masduq, the truthful one, the trusted one. Muhammad ibn Abdullah is telling us, an wuqu'i ghurbat al-Islam, that the strangeness of Islam is going to occur, and that it started off strange, and it will go back to that. The word tuba comes from the fu'la min at-tayyibi. Tuba comes from tayyib. It's the form of fu'la in the Arabic language. It means, falahum, for them is, kullu tayyibi fi dunya wal akhirah, every good there is in this world and the hereafter is for them. Wa humul fa'izuna bil hayati al akhirah, and they're the ones, the day of judgment, who are going to succeed by entering Jannah. The third evidence that the author brings in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, also Abu Huraira narrated it saying, وَمَنِ الْغُرَبَاء, who are the غُرَبَاء, أَنُّزَّاعُ مِنَ الْقَبَائِلِ, أَنُّزَّاعُ are, أي الْمُجْتَمِعُونَ مِنْ أَعْرَاقٍ شَتَّى وَأَنْسَابٍ مُتَفَرِّقَةٍ, they are a people who are from different backgrounds, different tribes. One is Pakistani, one is Bangladeshi, one is Indian, one is Somali, one is Arab. They're all together. What brought these people together? Nuzaa' min al-qaba'il, from different tribes and from different backgrounds. The only thing that brought them together was what? The sunnah and the tawheed is what brought them together. So they are united upon that. In the other riwayah, what did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Al-ghuraba alladhina yasluhuna idha fasada an-nas, they are the ones who are corrected matters once it has been made corrupt. The earth has taken on corruption. They come and they perfect it, they correct it. And Imam al-Ajurri narrated in a whole book he authored. He called it Kitab al-Ghuraba. Ad-Dani, he wrote a Kitab al-Fitan. He narrated this. The fourth evidence that the author brings is the hadith of Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqas. فَطُوبَ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْغُرَبَاءِ إِذَا فَسَدَ النَّاسِ, رواه أحمد وَرِجَالُهُ ثِقَاتٍ, which is the same meaning as the previous hadith. The fifth evidence that the author uses is the hadith of Auf ibn Zaydin. طُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَاءِ الَّذِينَ يُصْلِحُونَ مَا أَفْسَدَ النَّاسِ, Tirmidhi narrated it with isnaduhu da'if, and he's using it as he previously used the other evidences. Then the author chooses the hadith Abi Tha'labat al-Khushani, which is the sixth evidence. Abu Tha'labat al-Khushani was asked about the statement of Allah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu alaykum anfusakum la yadhurrukum man dhalla idha ihtadaytum. Oh, those of you who believe, upon you is yourself. Busy yourself with yourselves. La yadhurrukum, it will not harm you. Man dhalla, the one who becomes misguided, idha ihtadaytum, once you become guided. So he was asked about this ayah. Abi Tha'labat al-Khushani was asked about this ayah. And then he said, Ama wallahi, by Allah, لَقَدْ سَأَلْتَ عَنْهَا خَبِيرًا. I asked this ayah, the meaning of it, a wise one, knowledgeable one, meaning the messenger. سَأَلْتُ عَنْهَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I asked the messenger about this ayah. فَقَالَ, the messenger said to me, بَلْ اِتَمِرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, rather, call to the good. وَتَنَاهَوْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, prevent each other from evil. حَتَّى إِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ شُحًّا مُطَاعًا, when you see that the people are obeying stinginess, وَهَوَا مُتَّبَعًا, and the people are following their desires, وَدُنْيَا مُؤَثَّرَةً, and the dunya becomes affected, everybody becomes affected by the dunya, وَإِعْجَابَ كُلِّ ذِي رَأْيٍ بِرَأْيِهِ, everybody becomes self, everybody becomes opinionated, and they believe in their own opinions to be the right. فَعَلَيْكَ بِنَفْسِكَ, that time upon you is yourself. وَدَعَنْكَ الْعَوَامَّ, and leave of these general mass and the general folks. فَإِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ أَيَّامَ الصَّبْرِ, in front of you is days of patience that are needed. أَلْقَابِضُ فِيهِنَّ عَلَى دِينِهِ, the one who's holding on to his religion that day. كَالْقَابِضُ عَلَى الْجَمْرِ, is like one who's holding on to hot charcoal. لِلْعَامِلِ فِيهِنَّ, the one that's implementing the sunnah, holding on to the sunnah. مِثْلُ أَجْرِ خَمْسِينَ رَجُلًا, he is getting the reward of 50 men. يَعْمَلُونَ مِثْلَ عَمَلِكُمْ, that are doing the likes of your actions. قُلْنَا, we said, مِنَّا أَوْ مِنْهُمْ, from amongst them or from amongst us, 50 men from amongst us, the companions. The messenger said, بَلْ مِنْكُمْ, from you guys. Those ones, their action is going to be the action of 50 men from amongst you. رَوَاهُ أَبُو دَاوُدْ, and Tirmidhi narrated this. The way that the author is trying to take from this hadith, the hadith is weak in its chain of narration, but لكن لجمله, the overall meaning that is in it, it has شواهد تقويها, that strengthens it. Especially the last part where the Prophet says the reward of the one who is doing it. The author is trying to use this hadith from two different angles. The first one is to clarify to you غُرْبَةِ الْإِسْلَامِ, that Islam is strange in the days of patience. وَالْقَبْضِ عَلَى الْجَمْرِ, and holding on to the charcoal. And the second is that the reward of the one who is doing it that day is of the reward 50 companions of the Prophet. And the fact that the actions is multiplied to that amount shows you how virtuous this is. The seventh evidence that the author is using is the statement of the messenger, Inna min wara, sorry, the statement of Ibn Umar, Inna min ba'dikum ayyaman as-sabiru fiha, before you is ayyaman days, as-sabiru fiha, the patient one in it, al-mutamassiku bimithli ma antum alayhi al-yawma, lahu ajru khamsina minkum, that the one who is patient that day, the one who is holding on to his religion that day, is like بِمِثْلِ مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلِيهِ الْيَوْمِ لَهُ أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ مِنْكُمْ, 50 from amongst you's reward is what he's going to attain that day. This is narrated by Ibn Waddah, وَإِسْنَادُهُ ضَعِيفُ, his chain of narration is weak. And what suffices us is the statement of the narration of Abi Tha'labat al-Khushani رضي الله تعالى عنه. And the author is trying to use this as an evidence, just like he used the previous one as an evidence, or the way he used the previous one. The eighth evidence is hadith Sa'id al-Basri, Akhil Hassan al-Basri. Both of them are tabi'een. And they attributed this statement to who? The Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is a what? Mursal. Mursal is ma adafahu tabi'iyu ila nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam. It's what a tabi'i attributes to the Messenger. Wa hukmuhu da'fu. Weakness is his ruling. And that's what the line of poets says. Wa mursalu al-hadithi ma qad wusifa bi raf'i tabi'in lahu wa du'ifa. A mursal is what a tabi'i attributes to the Prophet, and its ruling is weakness. And the author is trying to use from this the same of that which he used from the previous, two. The ninth evidence is hadith Bakr ibn Amr al-Ma'arifi, Ma'afiri, rahimahullah, who is a tabi'i. He said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Tuba lil ghuraba." Ibn Waddah narrated this. And it is also da'if because it is mursal. A tabi'i is attributing it to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we already explained what this means when we were talking about the hadith of the Prophet, "Tuba lil ghuraba." Now,
باب التحذير من البدع عن العرباط بن الساريه
ما هو شده قال شده المسكين كان
ساريه رضي الله عنه قال وعظنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عوره مريضه وجلت منها القلوب وظرفت منها العيون قلنا يا رسول الله كانها موعظه مودع فاوصنا قال أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل والسمع والطاعة وإن تأمر عليكم عبد فإنه من يعش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا
ألف الوصل والرسول خبتها
فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي تمسكوا بها وعضوا عليها بالنواجذ وإياكم محدثات الأمور فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة قال الترمذي حديث حسن صحيح وعن حذيفة رضي الله عنه قال كل عبادة لا يتعبدها أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا تتعبدوها فإن الأول لم يدع للآخر مقالا فاتقوا الله يا معشر القراء وخذوا طريق من كان قبلكم رواه أبو داود وقال الدارمي أخبرنا الحكم بن مبارك أنبأنا عمرو بن يحيى قال سمعت أبي يحدث عن أبيه قال كنا نجلس على باب عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه قبل صلاة الغداء فإذا خرج مشينا معه إلى المسجد فجاءنا أبو موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه فقال أخرج عليكم أبو عبد الرحمن بعد قلنا لا قال فجلس معنا فلما خرج قمنا إليه جميعا فقال له أبو موسى يا أبا عبد الرحمن إني رأيت آنفا في المسجد أمرا أنكرته والحمد لله لم أر إلا خيرا قال فما هو فقال إن عشت فستراه قال رأيت في المسجد قوما حلقا جلوسا ينتظرون الصلاة في كل حلقة رجل وفي أيديهم حصى فيقول كبروا مئة فيكبرون مئة فيقول هللوا مئة فيهللون مئة فيقول سبحوا مئة فيسبحون مئة قال فماذا قلت لهم قال ما قلت لهم شيئا انتظار رأيك قال أفلا أمرتهم أن يعدوا سيئاتهم وضمنت لهم ألا يفوت من حسناتهم شيء ثم مضى ومضينا معه حتى أتى حلقة من تلك الحلق فقال ما هذا الذي أراكم تصنعون فقال يا أبا عبد الرحمن حصل نعد به التكبير والتهليل والتسبيح. قال فعدوا سيئاتكم فأنا ضامن ألا يضيع من حسناتكم شيء. وأيحكم يا أمة محمد ما أسرع هلكتكم. هؤلاء أصحاب محمد بينكم متوافرون، وهذه ثيابه لم تبلغ، وآنيته لم تنكسر، والذي نفسي بيده إنكم لعلى ملة هي أهدى من ملة محمد، أو مفتتحون باب الضلالة
أو مفتتحو
باب الضلالة. قالوا والله يا أبا عبد الرحمن ما أردنا إلا الخير. قال وكم من مريد للخير لن يصيبه. إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حدثنا أن قوما يقرؤون القرآن لا يجاوز تراقيهم. وأيم الله لا أدري لعل أكثرهم يكون منكم. ثم تولى عنهم. قال عمرو بن سلمة رأيت عامة أولئك الحلق يطاعنوننا يوم النهروان مع الخوارج.
The last chapter is Bab al-Tahdhir min al-Bid'ah, the chapter of warning against innovation. عن العرباض بن سارية رضي الله تعالى عنه قال وعظنا, the messenger warned us. Rasulullah, the messenger of Allah, maw'idhatan, he warned us a warning which was very tough. وجلت منها القلوب, the hearts moved. وظرفت منها العيون, the eyes watered. قلنا يا رسول الله, we said, O messenger of Allah, كأن maw'idhatum wad'in, it's like a farewell. It's like a what? Farewell greeting. فأوصنا, give us a farewell. قال أوصيكم, I give you a وصية بتقوى الله, to be pious and be conscious of Allah. والسمع والطاعة, and to listen and to obey Allah. وإن تأمر عليكم عبد, even if a slave it takes over your affairs. فإنه من يعيش منكم, for verily amongst you, فإنه من يعيش منكم, for whoever amongst you lives, فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا, he's going to see a lot of disputes and argumentations. فعليكم بسنتي, upon you is my sunnah, وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين, and the sunnah of my rightly guided خلفاء, من بعد who came after me. تمسكوا بها, hold on to that. وعضوا عليها بالنواجد, and grab it with your molar teeth. وإياكم, and stay away and be cautious of محدثات الأمور, the newly invented matters. فإن كل محدثة بدعة, because every newly invented matter is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة, and every innovation is what? Misguidance. The author here, rahimahullah, is talking about التحذير من البدع, to be cautious of innovation and to be scared of it, and to be worried about its dangers, so you can stay away from it and to not lean towards it. That's the meaning of the chapter here, that the author, rahimahullah, he mentions. Before that, he already spoke about two other powerful chapters. The first one was what? بَابُ مَا جَعَلْنَا الْبِدْعَةَ أَشَدَّ مِنَ الْكَبَائِرِ, that innovation is greater than what? And the second one, that the innovation is greater than major sins. And the second one is what? مَا جَعَلْنَا اللَّهَ اِحْتَجَرَ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ صَاحِبِ بِدْعَةَ, that Allah, he blocked the door of repentance from the innovator. And now he's concluding the whole book with التحذير من البدع, to be cautious of innovation and to stay away from it and not to fall into it. The author brings three evidence. The first evidence was the hadith of عرباض بن سارية, which I brought. And the way that the author is trying to use it as an evidence is from three different angles. The first one is that the messenger commanded us to hold on to the sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa after him. And the innovation is not the sunnah. Bid'ah ليست من سنته ولا سنة خلفاء الراشدين. And the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa, it's not from them. Rather, تناقضها فيجب الحذر منها. Rather, it opposes it and nullifies it, so it's obligatory to warn against it. The second way that the author is trying to use the hadith of عرباض بن سارية is the messenger تصريحه صلى الله عليه وسلم بالتحذير من البدع. The messenger directly, clearly said, وإياكم ومحدثات الأمور, be cautious of the newly invented matters. And the third one is, the Prophet ﷺ told us that أَنَّ كُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ, that every innovation is misguidance. And as we all know, misguidance is something that one should be very cautious of. The second evidence that the author uses is the statement of Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, which is, Hudhayfah said, كُلُّ عِبَادَةٍ, every ibadah, لَا يَتَعَبَّدُهَا أَصْحَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ, أَصْحَابُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, every ibadah which the companions of the Messenger did not worship Allah on, فَلَا تَتَعَبَّدُوهَا, don't worship Allah based on that ibadah. فَإِنَّ الْأَوَّلَ لَمْ يَدْعَ لِلْآخِرِ مَقَالًا, because the Sahabas and the early generation never left anything for the latecomers, for them to add on to. Everything was already done. That's it. For you there's only submission and following. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, fear Allah. يَا مَعْشَرَ الْقُرَّاءِ, those reciters amongst you, oh, those of you who believe in Allah. وَخُذُوا طَرِيقَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ, and take the path of those who came before you. That's the second evidence that the author, rahimahullah, uses. Abu Dawood narrated this, and Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi brought it in his kitab al-Ba'ith. And every scholar mentions that it's in Sunan Abi Dawood, but you won't find it in there. It's not in the Sunnah, in the Nusakh of our Sunan Abi Dawood that we have. Where is the author trying to use this? And what is he trying to extract from Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman's statement? Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman is warning us. He is warning us عن التعبد بما لم يتعبده أصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, not to worship Allah on anything that the companions did not worship Allah on. Because لو كان خيرا لسبقونا إليه, if there was good in it, then the companions would be the first to hasten to it. There's not a door of good except Abu Bakr wanted to get there before you. There's no door of good except Umar wanted to get there before you. There's no door of good except Uthman wanted to get there before you. There is no door of good except Ali ibn Abi Talib wanted to get there before you. وَسَائِرُ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, and all the other remaining companions. So if they knew that there was a road to enter Jannah, they would never delay. They would go it. And they would hasten to it. They are the ones who came to the Messenger and said, Ya Rasulullah, what is it that's going to bring us? أَيُّ عَمَلٍ يُقَرِّبُنِ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَيُبَعِدُنِ مِنَ النَّارِ, that would bring me close to Jannah and that would distance me from the hellfire. And then the Messenger said, the Prophet said to him, لَقَدْ سَأَلْتَ عَنْ عَظِيمٍ وَإِنَّهُ لَيَسِيرٌ عَلَى مَنْ يَسَّرَهُ اللَّهِ, you have asked about something great, but it's only easy for the person who Allah makes it easy for. They used to say to the Messenger, أَيُّ الْإِسْلَامِ أَحَبُّ أَيُّ الْعَمَلِ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ, which action is most beloved to Allah? So they wanted to enter Jannah from whatever door there was. So they would have taken that path. Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. And then the author brings the third evidence, which is the long hadith of that the author rahimahullah brings is a hadith that needs to be stood over for a bit. And the hadith is قال الدارمي أخبرنا الحكم بن المبارك أنبأنا عمرو بن يحيى قال سمعت أبي يحدث عن أبيه قال كنا نجلس على باب عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه. We were sitting at the door of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud قبل صلاة الغداة, just before the morning prayer. فإذا خرجنا مشينا معه إلى المسجد before فجر. And when they would sit at his door, when he came out, they would go with him to the masjid. نعم فجاءنا أبو موسى الأشعري. Whilst we were sitting at the door, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari came to the door of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. فَقَالَ, he said, أَخَرَجَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَبُو عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنُ بَعْدُ, has Abdullah ibn Mas'ud come out of his house yet? قُلْنَا لَا, we said no, we're still waiting for him. فَجَلَسَ مَعَنَا, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari then sat down waiting for Abdullah ibn Mas'ud to come out. فَلَمَّا خَرَجَ قُمْنَا إِلَيْهِ جَمِيعًا, when Abdullah ibn Mas'ud came out, all of us, we were sitting, we stood up. And when we stood up, فَقَالَ أَبُو مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari then said, Ya Aba Abdul Rahman, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ آنِفًا فِي الْمَسْجِدِ أَمْرًا أَنْكَرْتُهُ, I saw in the masjid a matter which I disagree with, which I rejected. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ لَمْ أَرَى إِلَّا خَيْرًا, but praises to Allah, I didn't see except good. Then he said, فَمَا هُوَ, what is it that you saw? And then Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, إِنْ عِشْتَ فَسَتَرَاهُ, if you live, you will see it. Meaning, they're there, you're going to see it now. قال رأيت في المسجد, I saw in the masjid قَوْمًا حِلَقًا جُلُوسًا, a people who were in circles in the masjid, يَنْتَظِرُونَ الصَّلَاةِ, they were waiting for the prayer. فِي كُلِّ حَلْقَةٍ رَجُلٍ, in each circle there's a man. وَفِي أَيْدِيهِمْ حَصَى, they had pebbles with them. فَيَقُولُ, they were saying, كَبِّرُوا مِئَةً, so each one, there's a man in there, he says, say Allahu Akbar 100 times. And then you go, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, 100 times. فَيُكَبِّرُ مِئَةً, فَيَقُولُ, he then says, هَلِّلُوا مِئَةً, say La ilaha illallah 100 times. And then they say 100 times. سَبِّحُوا مِئَةً, say Subhanallah 100 times. And then they say it. قَالَ فَمَاذَا قُلْتَ لَهُمْ, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, then what did you say? What did you say to them? قَالَ مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ شَيْئًا انْتِظَارَ رَأْيِكَ, I didn't say anything to them waiting for your opinion. قَالَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ بْنُ مَسْعُودٍ then said, أَفَلَا أَمَرْتَهُمْ, why didn't you command them, أَنْ يَعُدُّوا سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, that they sit down and they count their sins. وَضَمِنْتَ لَهُمْ, and that you promise them and reassure them, أَلَّا يَفُوتَ مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِمْ شَيْءٍ, that none of their good deeds will be, that they would miss out. ثُمَّ مَضَى, and then Mas'ud carried on walking. وَمَضَيْنَا مَعَهُ, and we carried walking with him. حَتَّى أَتَى حَلْقَةً مِنْ تِلْكَ الْحِلَقِ, until he came to one of those circles. Now Ibn Mas'ud is standing over it. فَقَالَ, he then said to them, مَا هَذَا الَّذِي أَرَاكُمْ تَصْنَعُونَ, what is it that I see you guys doing? فَقَالُوا, they said, يَا أَبَا عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ حَصَّنَ عُدُّ بِهِ التَّكْبِيرَ وَالتَّهْلِيلَ وَالتَّصْبِيحَ, it is only pebbles. We're counting Allah, we're saying Allahu Akbar with it. We're saying La ilaha illallah with it. We're saying Subhanallah with it. And then he said to them, فَعُدُّوا سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ, count your sins. فَأَنَا ضَامِنٌ أَلَّا يَضِيعَ مِنْ حَسَنَاتِكُمْ شَيْءٌ, none of your righteous deeds would you guys lose. وَيْحَكُمْ, destruction be to you. يَا أُمَّةَ مُحَمَّدٍ, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا أَسْرَعَ هَلَكَكُمْ, how close is your destruction. هَؤُلَاءِ أَصْحَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ, أَصْحَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ, these are the companions of the messenger. بَيْنَكُمْ مُتَوَافِرُونَ, they are large in number amongst you. They are large in quantity amongst you. وَهَذِي ثِيَابُكُمْ, وَهَذِي ثِيَابُهُ, and this is the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's garment. لَمْ تَبْلَ, it still hasn't worn out. وَآنِيَتُهُ, and the Prophet's vessels and his utensils that he was using. لَمْ تَنْكَسِر, it yet hasn't broken. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي, I swear by the Lord, in which my soul is in his hand. إِنَّكُمْ لَعَلَى مِلَّةٍ هِيَ أَهْدَى مِنْ مِلَّةِ مُحَمَّدٍ, you guys are on a religion more guided than the Prophet's religion. أَوْ مُفْتَتِحُ بَابَ ضَلَالَةٍ, or you guys are opening a door of this misguidance. قَالُوا, they said, وَاللَّهِ يَا أَبَا عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ, Abu عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, مَا أَرَدْنَا إِلَّا الْخَيْرِ, the only thing that we intended was good. And then he said to them, وَكَمْ مِنْ مُرِيدٍ, and how many people wanted خَيْر, لَنْ يُصِبْهَا, they didn't get the خَيْر that they were looking for. إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, the messenger of Allah صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, حَدَّثَنَا, he told us, أَنَّ قَوْمًا يَقْرَؤُونَ الْقُرْآنَ, there is going to come a group of people who are going to read the Qur'an. لَا يُجَاوِزُ تَرَاقِيَهُمْ, that Qur'an will not pass their throats. وَأَيْمُ اللَّهِ, I swear by Allah, لَا أَدْرِي, I don't know, لَعَلَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ, that the majority of you all, يَكُونُ مِنْكُمْ, that the majority of those which the messenger mentioned is going to be from amongst you. ثُمَّ تَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ, and then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud turned away from him. قَالَ عَمْرُ بْنُ سَلَمَةَ, the narrator of the hadith said, رَأَيْتُ عَامَةَ أُولَٰئِكَ الْحِلَقِ, I saw the majority of those people that day of Nehrawan when Ali was fighting with the Khawarij. It was them, the ones who were counting the pebbles. They turned out to be Khawarij. They were fighting Ali and they were trying to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in killing the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's cousin. Bid'ah starts with a step. It only started with a pebble and it turned into a sword. It turned into bloodshed. Innovation's quantity grows. Shaytan doesn't stop at a very small amount. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud used the hadith of the Khawarij for a people who were doing dhikr in the masjid, to show you that the Sahabas closed the door of innovation in totality. And that's the third evidence that the author was using. And the evidence is, you, the way he was trying to use it was from two angles. This story, the author was mentioning it from two angles. By the way, this hadith is Hasan. It is sound hadith and it's authentically transmitted from Ibn Mas'ud. Tirmidhi narrated it, Ibn Majah narrated it. It is authentically transmitted. The author is trying to use this hadith from two angles. The first one is that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud rejected this action from them, and how strong his statement was. He said to them, إِنَّكُمْ لَعَلَى مِلَّةٍ هِيَ أَهْدَى مِنْ مِلَّةِ مُحَمَّدٍ أَوْ مُفْتَتِحُ بَابَ ضَلَالَةٍ. You guys are either more guided than the messenger, or you're opening a door of misguidance. And the later of the two is what's meant by it. The second way that the author was trying to use this story was what? تَفَرُّسُهُ the firasa, which is the vision of Ibn Mas'ud and how he observed the matter, which is that these people were going to be the Khawarij. And how he was accurate in that statement of his, and that they turned out to be the battle of Nehrawan, of Ali ibn Abi Talib with the Khawarij, it turned out to be them. And وَهَذَا آخِرُ الْبَيَانِ عَلَى هَذِهِ الْجُمْلَةِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ. And this is the final book from the series of the barnamage of ضبط العلم, precision in knowledge. Any mistakes that I came with while I was explaining the books and while I was going through it, it's from me and Shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.